नमस्ते. हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर नरेंद्र गुप्ता. आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय होम्योपैथिक चैनल होम्योपैथी एंड लाइट. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब रेमेडी मेटल एल्यूमिना. सो आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्क्राइब दिस मेडिसिन इन हिंदी लैंग्वेज. सो दैट वाज अपलोडेड इन माय हिंदी चैनल होम्योपैथी एनलाइटन होम्योपैथी बाय डॉक्टर नरेंद्र गुप्ता. यू कैन आल्सो सब्सक्राइब दैट चैनल. दो यू मे नॉट बी नोइंग हिंदी, इवन देन सब्सक्रिप्शन माइट हेल्प द ऑडियंस इन वन और द अदर वे. सो एल्यूमिना इज ए पर्सन वो बिफोर फॉलिंग सिक, सिक मीन्स वेन ही बिकम्स रेडी टू कम टू द डॉक्टर फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट, फील्स हिमसेल्फ टू बी अ वेरी ग्रेट पर्सनैलिटी. This is very important. The rubric, whatever I describe here in the videos, I learn from the rubrics in the repertory, description given by various authors in different books, Materia Medicas, and my clinical experiences. So I combine all the things and make whatever is possible, whatever I have understood, to make this video. So he feels himself a great personality. The rubric in the repertory is given as delusion, great person is a. So this feeling of Illumina is further corroborated by many rubrics present in our Materia Medica. Some of them are, I am just reading it for you: ardent, audacious, barking like a dog, contemptuous, defiant, delusion, enlarged body is parts of body, especially neck. Delusion, large parts of body seems too large. Obstinate, headstrong, resist wishes of others. Expansive, too demonstrative. Growling like a dog. Grumbling, haughty. Jesting, trifles with everything. Meddlesome, importunate. Recognizing, not recognize, does relatives his. Striking, desire, strike to. Violent, vivacious. So these are few rubrics by which you can understand that Illumina patient is feeling himself great. Not the patient, but Illumina personality. So this kind of personality who feels himself great or later on is liable to be converted into Illumina patient. So we shall try to understand some of the rubrics given above, because all the rubrics cannot be explained. Some of them are self-explanatory, some of them are just are given in relation to the other rubrics. So few important rubrics need some kind of subtle explanation. So I am just going to explain few of them, which I suppose are very, very important to discuss. The first one is the major one: delusion, great person is a, means he feels that he is a great person. So to understand each rubric at the subtlest level, what is the procedure I adopt? So we should understand the subtle meaning of each word used in a particular rubric. Just like in this rubric, there are words delusion, great person, is a. So we should try to evaluate the meaning of each word. A is great, etc. Even those simple words, appearing simple words, we are supposed to analyze them. Only then we will be able to understand the in-depth meaning of particular rubric. Once you understand the meaning of particular rubric in depth, then gradually you will start understanding the personality of the drug. Because this rubric cannot be explained in isolation, it has to be corroborated with the other rubrics, that those are given in the description of that particular remedy. So we can take the help of रिपर्टरी, तो दैट इज ए बेस्ट वे, इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग टू द मेट्रिया मेडिका वी शुड फर्स्ट गो टू द रिपर्टरी एंड ट्राई टू एनालाइज दीज रूब्रिक्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ रिपर्टरी. एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन रीड मेट्रिया मेडिका बिकॉज इन मेट्रिया मेडिका फ्यू ऑथर्स हैव डिस्क्राइब दोज रूब्रिक्स इन देयर ओन लैंग्वेज. सो यू कैन गेट ए जीस्ट ए स्लाइट हिंट आउट ऑफ दीज मेट्रिया मेडिका दैट वट इज द नेचर ऑफ दिस रेमेडी. But you know, do not, please do not get biased with the description given by those authors, so-called great, great, great authors. So great authors can also commit mistakes. So just go through all the literature, get a picture out of it, some feel of the medicine, and then independently you analyze each and every rubric. If it fits into the explanation given by those authors, then only you accept. Otherwise, whatever explanation you feel is worth or is correct, then you depend on your own explanation, then you will grow. So Wu is a great person. Person means an individual, not a group. So any person having unusual high abilities, qualities, strength, popularities, etc., etc., means he must have some kind of extra things which average person do not have. So only then he can be called as a great person. So he feels himself above and much more capable than others. Delusion means delusion and large body is parts of body. Another rubric is delusion, large parts of body seems too large. Too large means larger than whatever is required. Having parts enlarged is not a physical sensation, but it is at a very subtle level, because these rubrics are given in mind section and that too under the heading of delusion. So for this particular person, the parts are large, even too large. Large is quite okay, but too large means larger than what they are supposed to be needed for a normal person. So once these organs are large, so it means he has got some extra powers which other people do not have. So this is the feeling. When you are above others, obviously you will not treat and have a great sense that you are above others, then obviously your behavior will be guided by this feeling. So all other rubrics given in the description of Illumina will be just a description of this feeling. Generally, while understanding a rubric in the repertory, we take its gross meaning, then convert it into its metaphorical sense. This is because we consider a human being at its gross level only, whereas a human being is a harmonious orchestra of 360 millions of different kind of energies. This is given in our all religious scriptures. So 350 millions of different kind of energies working in harmony with each other. So all the sensations, capabilities and reaction of a human being are the outcome of the functioning of these energies. So 350 million kinds of energy make a human body. So to understand a rubric, we should consider every word of the rubric at its subtlest level, meaning as if it is an echo indicating a kind of energy. For example, urine, cough, respiration, sweat, perspiration, sleep, awakening, etc., etc. There are so many words used in the mind section of the repertory, should not only be understood at their gross material level, but these words should also be understood as the sense conveyed by them at their subtlest level. So if we consider a human being as a living harmonious conglomeration of different energies controlled by super spiritual energy, what is that super spiritual energy? Dr. Hahnemann called it as a vital force. So super spiritual energy, then it becomes very easy to understand different rubrics at their subtlest level. So this understanding is essential एज वी यूज हाईली पोटेंटाइज्ड मेडिसन विच आर नथिंग बट द एनर्जीज. सो दे आर नथिंग बट एनर्जी एट ए वेरी सटल लेवल. बोथ बिकम सिमिलिमम टू ईच अदर ओनली एट ए वेरी सटल लेवल. सो ग्रॉस मीनिंग विल नॉट हेल्प अस. सो वेन एवर वी प्रिस्क्राइब रेमेडी बाय टेकिंग ग्रॉस मीनिंग ऑफ द रूब्रिक जस्ट लाइक स्लीप आफ्टर यूरिनेशन, तो दिस विल नॉट वर्क. वी हैव डायरेक्टली वी हैव सेवरल टाइम्स हैव द एक्सपीरियंस, बट इफ यू टेक द सटल मीनिंग ऑफ यूरिनेशन एंड सटल मीनिंग ऑफ स्लीप ओनली देन ए डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग विल अराइज. And if you base your prescription on that feeling, then it will act. So we have got the proof several times in our clinic. The sense conveyed by these rubrics is that all the capacities for which these organs are used are much above than what an average human being possesses. So this alumina patient feels that he has got certain extra powers with him. So he is great. As we sometimes use the proverb, the large hands of the law or large arm of the law. Hands are or arms are parts of the body that are used to catch hold of something. The proverb carries the sense that the law enforcing agencies have great powers, so no criminal can escape from them. He will ultimately one day be caught by those agencies. Indicating the long hands or long arms of the law. So this is the subtle meaning of long arms of the law. Though the law is not a human being and does not have hand in literal sense, so it is again we are using metaphorical meaning of the word long arms of the law. But if you see at their gross level, it means the law has got arms and those are very large. So it is not like that. In our day-to-day life, we use metaphorical meaning of all the words and also we understand the meaning of every word. But when it comes to the language of the patient, then we want to be able to understand the word the patient wants to say at its certain level. Then we take the gross meaning and ultimately we fail in our prescription. So beforehand means when the patient comes, you study the repertory and materia medica with an intention to go deeper at the subtle level, metaphorical level of the each word used in the rubrics of that particular remedy. So here, though the law is not a human being that does not have hands in literal sense of the word, these are just a organization. Similarly, we can apply the same sense of these rubrics of alumina, those which are given above. So this is a universal rule and can be applied to all the rubrics of every remedy. Means we have to take the metaphorical meaning of each and every word. This can be applied or should be applied to each remedy. When we say that all the body parts of an alumina patient are enlarged, it means if his hands are enlarged, this means that he has more powers, because hand represent powers, arm represent powers, meaning that he can work better than others. If his eyes are enlarged, it means bigger than the normal. It means he can see those qualities, negative qualities and also the positive qualities in a person, even though that person wants to hide them, or he is able to see these qualities. It means no one can hide anything from the eyes of alumina patient. This he himself feels. It may or may not be true. So, which usually a normal person cannot observe, that is, nothing can escape the vision of alumina personality. If he has a long nose, it means he can smell all the conspiracies going on around him. This is the meaning having long nose. And another meaning is long nose means he has got more ego more prestige in him, a sense of ego and sense of prestige in him. So this is another subtle meaning of having long nose. If he has long ears, it means he can hear even those talks which other people do not want him to know. Means he can sense the conspiracies going on against everything. So possession of all enlarged body parts make him a person of very high capacity than any other human being. So as he considers himself to be a great person, as described above, because of certain qualities, his behavior towards other human beings is governed by this feeling. So he does not behave appropriately with them in a civilized way. He treats them with contempt. He feels, what harm these minor diseases can do to me. So there is no need to bother about such simple diseases. I am much more powers than the disease power. So disease powers or diseases cannot overcome me. So he does not give any importance to anyone whom he considers less powerful and just blows off even the most serious matter. Means matter that need his immediate and deep attention. He just do not pay any heed to those things also. Means the rubric is trifles with everything. So this rubric means he considers even the most important matter as not of much importance and so does not pay any heed to it. This he does only by thinking himself to be a great person. So what harm can these matters bring him? It can be solved within seconds by me if I wish to do so. So he can at any time handle these with ease. He is much above all the powers that these matters involve. Another rubric is barking like a dog. So he barks over everyone like a dog, means Illumina patient. This means that he does not give much importance to anyone. Rather, he feels it is his right to say all kind of wrong or insulting things to everyone because he is a great person. And others are lower than him, so he has every right. So he can scold them, scorn them, or even treat them contemptuously. So he keep on saying all kind of dirty things to everyone. Another rubric is growling like a dog. So growl is a low threatening sound or angry complaint. Meaning, jaise for example, he growl out his answer. So an Illumina patient takes them for granted, means other human beings or other diseases or other powers. So scolding, threatening and showing his temper on others, thinking himself superior than others. So this is behavior amounts to the rubric barking like a dog. So if he says something, people do not pay any heed to it. So they say simply he is barking like a dog. So there is no need to worry about him. Or in anger also they can say. So when a person barks like a dog over other people, so other people do not pay much heed to it. So they think he is an idiot and just keep on barking like a dog. What does he think about himself? Another rubric is defiant. He is defiant means he does not believe in obeying the authorities. Because he is a great, so how the authorities can order him? So the force he is supposed to obey means authorities or to behave according to their wishes. Example, a servant openly disobeys his master, not accepting the domination of his master. Though he is a servant, but he thinks in reality he is not a servant. He has got more power, more understanding than his master is having. So whatever master says to him, he thinks, oh, it's okay, I will do myself according to my own thinking. So my master has nothing, no intelligence. So he behaves according to his own wishes, ignoring his master's order. So obviously this is going to irritate the master. Similarly, in metaphorical or at a subtle level, a defiant person does not yield to the overpowering diseases or circumstances or people, etc. He wants to throw them away and wants to live according to his own will and wish. For example, I will not live like this. Means under domination of anyone. I cannot live. So this disease can't take me over. Meaning, whatever disease is suffering from, he feels that this disease cannot do anything with me. I will not mold my lifestyle according to the disease, but I will take treatment and will cure the disease. I will get the disease cured or this problem resolved at any cost. These problems cannot overpower me because I am greater than these diseases or these overpowering things. So motto of Illumina is, no one can overpower me. He may not be overpowering others, but he does not like that others should overpower him, and he feels that no one has the strength to overpower him, neither human beings nor the circumstances. So it means no one can overpower me means I will live as I wish. So this defiant nature is an indicative of him thinking himself to be a great or powerful person, one who does not want to be dominated. Another rubric is grumbling. So all these rubrics are just reflecting his one feeling that he is great. So grumbling is to complain in bad tempered way, meaning to keep saying that you do not like something. Example, the students were always grumbling about the standard of food served to them in their hostel, but they do not have any courage to complain directly to the hostel authorities. So a grumbling person always keep on muttering something but does not complain it to the authorities, as he does not have that much courage. But at the same time, he does not accept the situation as it is. So this is a sign of considering oneself to be someone great but not all powerful. So greater person does not mean he is all powerful. So we can say that an Illumina person does not accept the domination but at the same time also lacks courage. So this is the stage that he develops when he faces some kind of domination that he finds difficult to overthrow it. Meaning this is the beginning of breaking down of a Illumina personality into Illumina patient. So by above description you can see how an Illumina personality, strong personality during healthy state start becoming a Illumina patient. Means he start gradually turning into a sick person. Another rubric is haughty. Arrogant, full of ego, proud and thinking himself to be better than others. This is sense conveyed by the word haughty. So even when he realizes that he is working, even when he realizes that he is wrong at this particular point, he will not accept it but will try to prove his point of view right by all kind of wrong methods because he knows that he is wrong. But still he does not accept that he is wrong, because if he accepts that he is wrong, proves that he is lower than the others. So to keep himself proving at a higher level than the others, he will not accept his mistakes. So this kind of behavior again shows that he considers himself better than others, so does not want to succumb to any dominating force. There is another rubric, expansive, too demonstrative. Expansive means this word is used about a person or his behavior when he possesses a behavior of talking a lot in an interesting way or in a friendly way. This is the meaning of word expansive. Demonstrative, a person showing especially loving feeling in front of others, practically showing, not just keeping loving feeling in his heart. Two, T-O-O, two. More than enough, or more than what is required at that particular time or situation. So this much demonstration is required, but he makes demonstrative manifolds. So Illumina is a person who exhibit his loving feeling or his entire attitude in front of others without any hesitation. This needs a very courageous attitude. So in the beginning, Illumina is courageous, very bold. So this can only happen if he is not afraid of others. Another rubric is meddlesome. So weak people do not